You may not have realized it, but your bathroom is one of the most dangerous places in the home, and accidental falls account for the majority of injuries. If you're feeling unsteady getting in and out of the tub, or that you have a family member who's having difficulty in the bathroom, maybe it is time to make your bathroom more safe. Joining me today with safety ideas is Mary Rubin, owner of Simple Bath Ohio. Mary, nice to have you here.
Good to see you, Gail.
I didn't know this statistic, that really the bathroom is the most dangerous room in the home.
It really is, and particularly for seniors. We hear it all the time, and especially it's really appropriate this time of year to have this conversation. Many of us have spent time over the holidays with loved ones, aging parents, and so forth, and siblings get together, brothers and sisters, nieces and nephews talk. Mom and Dad, are you having a little bit more trouble getting around safely in the bathroom?
Oh, you're starting to see them all through the holidays.
Exactly.
And you're with them more than usual, and you notice those things.
Mm-hmm.
I know you brought some simple suggestions for folks, so let's take a look at a few things that people can do to make their baths safer. And I know these are great ideas mm-hmm. for anybody. And there's that first one. That cabinet height, which I hadn't thought about, but wow, what a difference that would make.
We are seeing more and more people go to taller cabinets, about 33 to 34 inches. If you can imagine, when you step up to that vanity to even brush your teeth, wash your face, it's so much safer to have it a little bit higher rather than that low vanity that you have to lean over.
And add lighting, it sounds so simple, but a lot of times our bathrooms are dimly lit. Brighten it up so you can really see where those trouble spots
are. Brighter lighting, one of the simplest solutions of all.
Replace the old commode with a higher commode.
Mm-hmm. All of the commodes that we're seeing today, the most popular thing is called a comfort height commode. If you can just imagine a commode that's about the height of a dining chair rather than sitting down on the old style commode, simple, simple fix.
A grab bar, and I think those not just in the bath or shower, but everywhere probably help.
Mm-hmm.
A seat in the shower, or even better, which you brought today.
We
which
did.
Which I hadn't even thought about. What are we looking at here, Mary?
This is a walk-in tub, and as big as it looks, believe it or not, Gail, this tub fits in exactly the same space as your traditional bathtub, which is about 60 inches long.
Yeah, I guess it would.
It does fit right in there. No special electrical is needed. No special plumbing is needed. We take out the old tub, put in the walk-in tub. Do you want to sit down in it for a minute?
Yeah, I'd like to give it a try.
Okay, like a test drive.
Well, you brought it here. I might as well. It's
Absolutely.
Got a grab bar right here.
Right.
Okay, so you just sit in here and then you use a sprayer to make sure you get everything that you want clean.
Gail, this is like the Maserati of walk-in tubs. You can do everything in this tub. You close the door, fills up. You can soak right here up to, you know, upper arm level. Pull this out, handheld shower, wash your hair. And interestingly enough, for people in your home who prefer not to take a bath but take a shower, this tub can be configured with sliding glass doors or even a shower curtain, so you can stand up in here and take a shower as well. You still have the seat, or you can stand up. And there are a couple of features about the tubs that we install that are different than the other walk-in tubs on the market. Number one, we customize these tubs locally, so they're not the ones you see on TV. Call this 800 number. Tub comes from California or Florida. These are customized locally right here in Worthington. So whatever features you want, grab bars, water jets, air jets, right here in Columbus.
And we're looking at some video of the process. And
right.
Really, as you said, sometimes all you have to do is take out that existing bath or shower and put this in, and it's not that difficult.
It's not that difficult at all. So it's a great solution for many, many people of all ages, not just seniors, but anybody who's got mobility or accessibility issues in the bathroom.
Here's a question, though. It fills up with water. So do you have to stay in there while the water drains?
Perfect question. And we know it's not a silly question. We get asked that all the time. And here's one of the key differences that we've incorporated into our tubs that is very unique in the market. If you can move your hand for a second, mm-hmm. there's a button right here.
Yep.
When you're in this tub, it's filled up with water, you've been sitting there soaking, you're ready to get out, push that button. We've got a drain in this tub that's a power drain. It will literally suck all the water out, not you, but the water, in less than a minute, about 58 seconds. So when you're ready to get out, push the button, boom, you're done.
What is start to finish of a project like this, for the most part, Mary?
For the most part, start to finish is about 2 days.
Which is simple.
Mm-hmm.
It is simple.
Hence the name, Simple Bath.
We've had your information up there, Mary. But the best way for folks to get a hold of you, email, phone,
email, phone, it's all on the screen probably. We're a local company, we're not a franchise. When you call our number, somebody, a live person right here in Columbus in our showroom in Worthington, Ohio, answers the phone, sets a time for us to come out and not sell you a walk-in tub, but take a look at your situation and come up with a customized solution that fits your needs.
Sounds good, Mary. Thank you so much, and thanks for bringing this in. This is kind of fun. Yeah.
Thanks, Gail. Good to see you again.